that kind of, or? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
1960, Madeline Dring was married to the oboist Roger Lord, who played for many years as the principal oboist in the London Symphony Orchestra. And I imagine that the Italian dance she was thinking of is the tarantella, which was said to be a fast and furious dance that people did when they'd been bitten by a tarantula and were going mad and trying to get rid of the poison. So I hope I've done that. And we'd like to thank you for listening to our concert as part of Ensemble Reza's series, and thank them for inviting us to do it. This is Gavin Roberts, my very dear friend and the music director at St. Marylebone Parish Church. And my name is Clare Hoskins. I'm an orchestral oboist, but I also sing in the choir at St. Marylebone. We'd like to play for you next a sonata by Bach. I hesitate to say which Bach, because it's currently attributed to C.P.E. Bach, but it was originally thought to be by Johann Sebastian, and I believe it is by Johann Sebastian Bach. I think there are several moments in it where the Neapolitan harmonies, where it becomes flatter in the key, they're so like other moments in pieces that are most definitely by Bach, by J.S. Bach, that I believe this is his. There's also some discussion about for which instrument it was originally written. The flautists claim it as their own, so do violinists. But I think it must have been written for the oboe. It doesn't go anywhere like as high in the register as a flute could go. It's too low for the recorder. It doesn't go low enough for the violin to employ its G string. And there are also bars of rest, which is very kind to an oboist, it's a tiring instrument to play, which Bach doesn't tend to put in his violin sonatas. And in the slow movement, you'll hear that there are beautiful, long, long, sustained notes underneath which the keyboard is playing, the Siciliana type rhythms. And some of those notes are longer than you could expect a flautist or a recorder player to hold. So I believe it's a sonata in G minor for the oboe and cembalo written by J.S. Bach, and I hope you'll enjoy it.
Thank you.
And I come closer to the camera so you can hear me speak clearly. I'm going to play a piece now to give Clare a break. We're moving to the music of Johannes Brahms, who is connected to the next few pieces we're going to do, actually, because both this and the Schumann we're about to hear in a minute are dedicated to Clara Schumann. But these pieces date from late in Brahms' life, from 1893, and from his collection of Opus 118, I'm going to play the A major Intermezzo number 2 from that collection, which was dedicated to his lifelong friend Clara Schumann. These are wonderful pieces and probably some of his best loved piano music. And you can hear a real sense of introspection, resignation, looking back on, you can almost imagine the older Brahms looking back on his life, fond memories, perhaps some unrequited love of his dear Clara Schumann. Anyway, here's number 2 in A major, Andante Tenaramente, which I think tells you all you need to know about the piece.
Thank you.
you, Gavin, both for your beautiful playing and for the break and the reminder that I need to stand forward to talk about the music. We'd like to play for you now Schumann's Three Romances, Opus 94, which were written in December 1849, which was thought to have been one of Robert Schumann's manic periods. He had written a couple of other pieces for wind instruments earlier that year, the Adagio and Allegro for French horn, which is often arranged for other instruments as well, and also some clarinet and piano pieces. But the Three Romances are thought to be his only chamber works specifically for the oboe. He wrote them in December of that year. He said that he wrote the first one on December the 7th and then the other two on December the 11th and 12th. And he then gave the three pieces to Clara Schumann for a Christmas present. But I like to think it's a present for anyone called Clara or Claire. And I think the music shows that it was during a manic period. You'll hear peace, calm, love, but also rage, fury, confusion. And in the last one, it's as if Schumann can't quite find the feelings. It keeps stopping and pondering and then moving on. But they are absolutely beautiful pieces. The first and the third are in A minor, and the central one is in A major.
Thank you. Thank you.
next going to play a piece by Gerald Finzi, Claire and I discovered this piece last year because we were due to play it at the St Marlebon Festival in St Marlebon Parish Church, where we both work every Sunday, well, used to work every Sunday. And Finzi has connections with the local area, and it's a wonderful piece, and he wrote this interlude for oboe and string quartet in the years that he was teaching at the Royal Academy of Music, which is right opposite St Marlebon Parish Church. And it was in 1932 that he wrote this piece, and it's thought that it was possibly originally conceived as an oboe concerto or even an oboe suite. And I think you can certainly hear in the oboe writing, there are elements of quite virtuosic oboe writing. And this version I'm going to play was created in the 1980s by Howard Ferguson. It's a version for piano and oboe, so I'm going to be doing my best impression of a string quartet as I play. But I think we discovered this piece last year and we really fell in love with it. It's got such a variety of moods, and those of you who know Finzi's music, and by the way, I have a vested interest because I'm on the committee of the Finzi Friends, so I'm also keen on championing this wonderful music. But you'll hear Finzi's recognisable style, particularly with the kind of clashing harmonies and very telling dissonances. So we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Well, we have to imagine that you're applauding rapturously and that you might like an encore. But before we play you some things for fun, we must thank Ensemble Reza for inviting us to be a part of their concert series, which is every Tuesday at noon, I believe. I first worked for Ensemble Reza at the end of January, when they were having online community orchestra rehearsals. I think many of their players were missing the live music making together, as all musicians are. And so I became the oboe coach for the online rehearsals. And but I can't tell you how wonderful it is to be able to rehearse and make music with a purpose. So thank you very much to Ensemble Reza, and in turn to their funders, the People's Postcode Trust and the Sussex Community Foundation. Thank you. It's really lovely, and thank you all for listening, because without an audience, it's not the same giving a concert, and we have to imagine that you're there, but thank you if you are. We'd like to finish with a little medley of songs from the shows, which I shall find now. We're going to start with A Nightingale Sang in Berkeley Square by Manning Sherwin, and then Send in the Clowns by Sondheim, and lastly Over the Rainbow by Harold Arlen. There'll be a little bit of singing, a little bit of oboe playing, and beautiful piano playing from Gavin Roberts.
Perfectly willing to swear that it has you.
Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue.